Evaluate 1/2 plus 3/5 times 5/7. We will remember our order of operation. Remember, parentheses comes first, then exponents and roots, then multiplication and division from left to right, and addition and subtraction working from left to right. In this problem, we do not have any parentheses or exponents. So we will check those off, and we will start with our multiplication and division. Here we have multiplication that we need to do first. We see that we have 3/5 times 5/7. We have a common factor in the numerator and denominator of 5 that we can divide out. 5 divided by 5 is equal to 1, and 5 divided by 5 is equal to 1. So then we multiply our numerators together. 3 times 1 is equal to 3. And 1 times 7 is equal to 7. Now we need to add. We are going to add 1/2 plus 3/7. When you add, you need a common denominator. The least common multiple of 2 and 7 is 14. So we need to write these fractions with 14 as the denominator. I multiplied this denominator by 7 to get 14. So I need to multiply the numerator by 7 as well. I multiplied 7 times 2 to get 14, so I need to multiply the numerator by 2, and I get 6. We have the same denominator, so we will add our numerators. 7 plus 6 is equal to 13, and we keep the denominator. So 13/14 is the answer to this problem. Evaluate 5/8 divided by 9/10 times 3/7. Again, we need to follow order of operations. We do parentheses, then exponents and roots, then multiplication and division, then addition and subtraction. This problem does not have any parentheses or exponents and roots, so we will start with multiplication and division working from left to right. We see we have a division and then a multiplication. So we will work on dividing these fractions first, moving from left to right. So when we divide, we keep the first fraction, we change the operation to multiplication, and then we flip, or take the reciprocal of, the second fraction. And I will just write this part of the problem down as I work through this problem. So I'm focusing on these two fractions here, and I'm going to now multiply. I have a common factor of 2 in the numerator and denominator with the 8 and the 10. So we will divide by 2. 8 divided by 2 is equal to 4, and 10 divided by 2 is equal to 5. Now we will multiply these numerators together. 5 times 5 is equal to 25. And 4 times 9 is equal to 36. And we will write the rest of the problem down. Remember, when we do problems like this, we make one change and write everything down, keeping each line equal to the previous line. We are multiplying again, so we look for any factors we could divide out in the numerator and the denominator. I see a factor of 3 in this numerator and a factor of 3 in this denominator, so we will divide them both by 3. 3 divided by 3 is 1, and 36 divided by 3 is 12. Now we can multiply across. 25 times 1 is equal to 25, so that is our new numerator, and 12 times 7 is equal to 84. So our answer to this problem is 25 over 84. Evaluate 3/8 times the quantity 5/6 minus 1/4. We need to remember our order of operation. We will start with parentheses. We will subtract inside the parentheses and determine what this equals as our first step. We are subtracting 5/6 minus 1/4. We do not have a common denominator, and we need a common denominator because we are subtracting. The least common multiple of 6 and 4 is 12. So we need to write these fractions with a denominator of 12. We multiplied 6 times 2 to get 12. So we need to multiply this numerator times 2. 5 times 2 is 10. We multiplied 4 times 3 to get 12. So we need to multiply the numerator times 3. So our new numerator is 1 times 3, which is 3. We have the same denominator, so now we will subtract the numerators. 10 minus 3 is equal to 7. So now we have finished simplifying our parentheses. We do not have any exponents and roots, so now we need to do our multiplication and division step. We have a multiplication problem here, 3/8 times 7/12. We see that we have a common factor in the numerator and denominator of 3. We can divide this numerator by 3 and that denominator by 3. So let's do that. 3 divided by 3 is 1, and 12 divided by 3 is 4. Notice every line, as we write down, is equal to the previous. There are no other common factors we can divide out in the numerator and denominators, so we will multiply our numerators together. 1 times 7 is 7, and 8 times 4 is 32. So our answer is 7 over 32. Evaluate 6 times 3/4 squared minus 7/8 to the 0 power. We need to remember our order of operations. We start with parentheses. There's nothing to simplify inside of the parentheses, so that step we don't need to do. We do have some exponents, so that's what we'll do next. We will raise 3/4 to the second power, which means we will multiply 3/4 times itself. And we have 7/8 to the 0 power. Any number to the 0 power, no matter whether it's a fraction, or a decimal, or a whole number, any real number raised to the 0 power is equal to 1. We learned that back in another section. So let's write what 3/4 squared means. It means 3/4 times 3/4. And anything to the 0 power is equal to 1. 3 times 3 is equal to 9, and 4 times 4 is equal to 16. So now we have finished our exponents and roots step, and now we need to do our multiplication and division. We have a multiplication part right here. We need to write this 6 as a fraction in order to multiply. Any integer can be written as a fraction by writing it over 1. We need to multiply that times 9 over 16. We see we have a common factor of 2 in this numerator and this denominator. So we will divide 6 by 2 and get 3, and 16 divided by 2 is equal to 8. Now we will multiply our numerators together. 3 times 9 is 27, And 1 times 8 is 8. So now we have finished our multiplication step, and now we need to do our addition and subtraction. Notice we have 27/8 minus 1. We need to write this as an improper fraction, and we can write that as 1 over 1. 1 over 1 is equal to 1. So now we need to find a common denominator in order to subtract. The common denominator of 8 and 1 would be 8. So I need to write this with both of these fractions with a denominator of 8. The first fraction's denominator I didn't change, so I don't change the numerator. This denominator I multiplied by 8, so I need to multiply the numerator by 8. So 8 over 8, isn't that equal to 1? Yes. So now we are going to subtract our numerators. 27 minus 8 is equal to 19 over 8. This is our answer as an improper fraction. We can change to a mixed number by putting the numerator inside of the division sign and putting the denominator outside. 8 divides 19 twice with 3 left over. Our remainder is our numerator, and what we divided by is our denominator. So this is the answer as a mixed number, 2 3/8.